70 years ago, there was a mass political mobilization in Kashmir. Tens of thousands of Kashmiris took to the streets of Srinagar, and they were protesting against their Maharaja. They were protesting in favor of the Kashmiri nationalist leader, Sheikh Abdullah, but they were also protesting in support of Indian rule. Now, of course, things have changed, but 70 years ago, the mood on the streets of Kashmir was very strongly pro-India.
Maharaj Harish Singh joined India naturally when he was threatened, naturally when he was attacked. Maharaja, look at the greatness of that Maharaja. Maharaja means king, the monarch. He was from Jammu, he was Dogra, he was from the same family I belong to. He studied in England. He knew the etiquettes of a secular society. He knew the meaning of brotherhood.
India was partitioned in 47, and a sizable chunk of Hindus from Punjab, they came to Jammu just to have a shelter, because they were killed there, some of them were killed there. And then they, reaching Jammu, they started telling the stories of their killings, other things, and molestation and all that. And this has a natural reaction. The Jammu Hindus, they turned against the Muslims who were residing in Jammu. They started killing them. And finally, Muslim conference of this Muzaffarabad and Mirpur, they declared a provisional government. They declared their independence, and people from Punjab, this Pakistan side, Mujahideen, the tribals like Faridis, Pathans and Peshawaris, they came to help and stabilize this Azad government that had been declared by these Punchis and these Muzaffarabad people.
There was an accession that was signed that was conditional. Conditioned on the basis that the Maharaja, who was the authority to accede, would consult his people. And this was something that was imposed on him by Lord Mountbatten and Jawaharlal Nehru, the first Prime Minister of India. And that agreement was that in addition to the accession being sort of conditional, there was a partial sort of abdication, if you will, of sovereignty in three areas. The three areas being defense, foreign affairs, and communication. I think a sort of sizable portion of the population was probably happy, because they were siding with Sheikh Abdullah at the time, and they agreed to it on the basis of assurances that were given to Sheikh Abdullah and the people of Kashmir at that time. There was, I think, also a sizable sort of segment of the population that was unhappy with it, but could not sort of react because of a fairly sort of overall hold that Sheikh Abdullah had over the population.
Kashmir became part forcibly through this phony and fake accession. It became a part of, but the undercurrent, people were not in favor of that accession at all. And there were a small minority who supported Sheikh Abdullah, because Sheikh Abdullah was the main person who facilitated the accession. He collaborated with the government of India, but he had his own compulsions. He wanted to grab the power. He wanted to become the Sultan of Kashmir. So he acceded. He supported the accession.
So 7 decades on, and Kashmir is still blighted by conflict. It's changed. The security situation isn't as bad as it was in the early 1990s, but this is not simply a dispute between India and Pakistan. It's also a conflict between the Indian state and the Indian army and young Kashmiris. Not all young Kashmiris, but most young Kashmiris, I think, are opposed to Indian rule, and they resent the presence of the Indian army, and they feel they have no agency about how their state is governed, and they're angry.